Hello all, my name is Ashutosh Rastogi. I'm a teacher by profession. My mission is to impart quality education for all. For that purpose, I'm creating these videos. If you appreciate my work, then please do like my video and subscribe my channel so that I could get the motivation to prepare more videos. Anyways, today in this concluding part of multiple access technique, we will going to discuss about space division multiple access. So these are the outlines. We'll going to start up with the introduction. Then we will going to discuss various specifications of your space division multiple access, which will be followed by the problems with the SDMA, which basically occurs in the reverse link. Then we will going to discuss solutions to the problem imposed by reverse link in the SDMA. And finally, we'll going to conclude by discussing some of the disadvantages of your SDMA systems. So in our earlier lecture, we have discussed about the multiple access environment where multiple users are competing to acquire the link so that they can transmit their information obviously in the interference limited environment. What we have learned from our earlier discussion that channel can be divided into four dimensions such as its time, frequency, code and space by which we can provide the interference limited environment for the information exchange. We have also learned about various contention free protocols such as your FDMA, TDMA and CDMA. In our last lecture, we have discussed about code division multiple access technique, which is the example of your spread spectrum multiple access technique, its various advantages, disadvantages and the application areas along with the comparison among FDMA, TDMA and CDMA. So now moving forward, in this particular lecture, we will going to discuss another channelization mechanism, which is your space division multiple access. So now next multiple access technique is your SDMA. So SDMA is nothing but it is your space division multiple access. So what we will going to do in our SDMA is it is used for allocating the separated space to users in the wireless network. Since in channelization, we have to provide interference limited environment or interference free environment for the users who want to transmit their information on the common medium. So if we want to restrict the interference, then in any of the three conditions, we have to negate one condition. That is, we have to limit that no two users should have transmit on the same time, or we should limit any two users should not use the same frequency band. Or in the third case, we should limit that no two users should transmit in the same space. So here in this particular scenario, what it is representing is we are exploiting multiple directional antennas. So all these users who are spatially apart to each other, they can use the same time as well as same frequency for transmitting their information. So with the help of these directional antennas or spot beams antennas, we are restricting the overlapping of the signals of multiple users. So this is how we are avoiding the interference. So SDMA serves different users by using spot beam antennas. So this is what we have seen in our last figure, that instead of having one isotropic antenna, they will be having multiple directional antennas whose coverage would have been called as your spot beam. So a typical application involves assigning an optimal base station to the mobile phone user. So if we talk about the typical application, so it mainly deals with assigning the optimal base station to the mobile phone users who want to transmit or receive its information. So this particular figure is showing the example of your sectored antenna. So here sectored antenna considered as the primitive application of SDMA. So obviously here we are assigning a specific sectored antenna to individual users so that they could communicate with the help of this base station, although they are exploiting same time and same frequency bands. But still, since they are distant apart, or their signal will not going to overlap with each other, that is how we are limiting the interference. So in future, adaptive antennas simultaneously steer energy in the direction of many users at once. So if we talk about futuristic adaptive antennas, by adaptive antennas, we mean that here antenna should in a state to modify their coverages depending upon the requirement imposed by the users. So in future, the adaptive antennas simultaneously change the energy in the direction of many users at once. As it is shown in this particular figure, you can easily check out with this particular figure that here the lobe's strength and its width as well as its length is different, and it is keep on changing depending upon the presence of user.
So typically, SDMA is never used in isolation, but it is always used in the combination with one or more of the multiple access schemes, such as your FDMA, TDMA, or CDMA, or we could say that FDMA as well as TDMA. So what are the major problems with the SDMA? So reverse link presents the difficulty in cellular systems. We had already talked about forward link as well as the reverse link. So in forward link, signal will be transmitted from base station to mobile station, whereas in the reverse link, mobile station will going to transmit its signal to the base station. So this should be quite clear. So reverse link basically presenting the difficulty in the cellular system. So different propagation path exists from user to the base station, obviously depending upon the location of the users and different types of physical environments, different propagation paths might get exist. So dynamic control of the transmitting power from each user to the base station is required. Since channel condition would have been changed in runtime, so we obviously need a dynamic control for transmission of power. So in the forward link, all the power control would have been done by your base station, since it is having the sole authority and it is transmitting to all the users. But when we will going to discuss about your reverse link, scenario might get changed. While considering our reverse link, transmitted power will also going to limit by the battery consumption of the subscriber unit. So which also limits the degree to which the power may be controlled on the reverse link. So if we do not have the sole control for the transmitted signal power, the signal quality might get affected. So the possible solution is that the base station should use the spatial filter for each user, for that adaptive antennas promise to mitigate reverse link problems. So the possible solution for this reverse link problem is base station should use a spatial filter in conjunction with the adaptive antennas, which promise to reduce the reverse link problems. So in the limiting case, the infinite similar beam width and infinitely fast track ability, adaptive antennas can implement optimal SDMA, thereby provide unique channel that is free from the interference. So obviously, if we consider the limiting case, depending upon the location of the user, we might be require a beam width which is infinitely small, and side by side we can also to have the tracking capability which is infinitely fast, or we could say that almost instant. So if an adaptive antenna can implement with such sort of ability, then we could say that we can provide unique channel that is free from the interference. So with the help of adaptive antenna system, all users communicate at the same time using the same channel and can track all the individual multipath component of all the users. So obviously, if we have implement all the above mentioned capability to our adaptive antenna systems, then all the users can communicate at the same time using the same channel, and we can also track all the individuals multipath component of all users. Obviously, it is the case for ideal adaptive antenna systems. So now the disadvantage of SDMA systems are, perfect adaptive antenna is not feasible, just because of why we are saying that it basically demands infinitely large antenna, so which is not possible. And obviously, if it is not possible, then we need to take a compromise between the antenna gain, antenna size, and the directivity. And if we will going to take the compromise between these parameters, obviously the signal quality will get affected. So these are the disadvantages of your SDMA systems. So hopefully you people have get the idea about the space division multiple access, what are the various problems associated with the space division multiple access environment, and how we will going to solve with the help of adaptive antennas. In case of any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. I will try to solve them out as soon as possible. These are the references. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.